Welcome to Athletes Unlimited Volleyball from Dallas, Texas, where the gold jersey has been more pyrite in recent weeks, but the Big Beth is trying to continue to restore the luster and value to the top spot. It's time to face down number two. Team Valentin-Anderson takes on Team Dela Cruz. Welcome inside, everybody. Kevin Barnett alongside former pro Heather Cox. And Heather, the focus has to be on the champion in waiting right now, Bethany Dela Cruz, two away.
Absolutely. Betty Dela Cruz just continues to create separation on that leaderboard with another 300-point match last night. She has dominated from day one, pure power and consistency. Now for Team Valentin-Anderson, keep your eye on Lindsay Stahls, or consistently a high draft pick, because she's a consummate pro. She's played professionally for 16 years, the type of player everyone wants on their team.
Both outside hitters. Championships are won and lost at the pins. First serve on the way.
Athletes Unlimited Volleyball on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Guaranteed Rate and by Dick's Sporting Goods.
Tonight's match is presented by Geico. For bundling made easy, go to geico.com. We are inside Fair Park. Dela Cruz and Valentin-Anderson set to go. No delays to your volleyball action here on your Friday night cap. Serve to Stalzer right away, and that ball, was it touched at the net? No, it was not. First point will go to the gold jerseys. Look at the starting lineup for Team Valentin-Anderson. Look for the battle in the middle. Sambothi and Ari Schutt had a fantastic start to the weekend. Valines will also be a target on the outside, and Erica Wilson has been coming on late. That opposite spot key for so many clubs. The line's roll shot covered, but not quite enough. Nearly there was Benson. How about for Team Dela Cruz? But Donnie Dela Cruz trying to get the championship, and it's another Cruz of the Ari variety helping her get there, coming off her best match of the year.
Absolutely. That she is the reason that this team is 1-0 this week. A double-double. And I also love that Nusara Tomcom got all five hitters involved last night. They'll want to do the same thing tonight.
Ari Cruz's numbers last night, 12 kills, hit 345 in efficiency, two aces, along with a block and 14 digs.
By far her most complete match of this Athletes Unlimited season.
And she was served. They served her 25 times.
Yep, doing it all.
Yeah, under duress. Going after the Big Beth here. Outside Kalei Mao. Can't put that one away. And Badania on the right-hand side there. Mao is a big question mark at the opposite position.
Absolutely. She would be the first to tell you she was not satisfied with her performance last night. She had four kills, but five errors on 15 swings. So hitting negative, she needs to step up those numbers tonight.
Here's Badania. The lone big, pure jump serve you'll see in the league. There's that line shot you were calling for last night, Heather. Tip from Wilson, smartly done by another pro's pro.
And I think Erica Wilson is the X factor for this team. It was a big question mark who would play opposite, and she has stepped in and stepped up.
Let's go down to Key Michael, the third member of our crew, the Olympian. There she is. Hi, Key.
Hi guys, I'm sideline. I'm gonna try and get you guys as close as possible to the action, but I'm also gonna tell you my player to watch today is Nusara Tomcom. Not only is she an amazing player, she's also an entrepreneur. She has her own line of juice, and I don't think it's an exaggeration when I say I'm not the only one that's excited to see her. She has literally millions of fans worldwide, and for good reason. She was selected in the first round all 5 weeks. I love that she smiles every time she plays. She's an experienced player, and at this point in her career, she can just enjoy it. So enjoy watching her.
We have enjoyed watching her this entire season. Thanks, Key. Nusara Tomcom, an international superstar, and that is not hyperbole.
Well, it's been a pro since she was 17 years old, and it shows.
Speaking international superstars, more like international volleyball assassins. Bethania Dela Cruz, who has played all over the planet in her second season here with us.
Yeah, I love what an international team this is for Dela Cruz from Dominican Republic, Ari Cruz, Puerto Rico. We've got Nusara Tomcom, of course, from Thailand, Namaris Velez Agosto, Puerto Rico. I could go on forever, but I won't, because that's it.
Good start for the women in gold. Tori Dilfer there just out of college. A nice mix of younger players along with experience. Veronica Stone right there on the bottom right of your screen. Out of Oregon. Benson, did she get ace? Not yet. Stalzer chases it down. What a delivery. Exactly to Key Michael's point. Nutsara Tomcom. You know, this last week, every other week you had to be concerned you might play with someone the following week. You don't have to worry about that anymore.
Exactly. You can hurt people's feelings.
You can talk some trash.
And there was a lot of trash talk in match one, too. It was kind of feisty. I liked it.
We'll see how it goes here. We're off to a very spicy start. It's getting a little hot for Team Valentin-Anderson. Someone get some milk during the timeout. The middles are meaningful. Jenna Rosenthal has had an explosive first season.
Yeah, Veronica Stone and Jenna Rosenthal need to combine tonight to do well. Watch the real estate that Jenna Rosenthal covers from left to right on the slide. Such an offensive power, especially off of one leg. And then check out the lateral movement for the block. Has a very unusual swing block technique. Lands on one foot sometimes right there, but it works. She gets the timing perfectly, averaging 2 kills per game. Hitting a blistering 367 on the season and averaging about half a block per set to get it done. Now, you talk about the red hot list, Kevin. You've got to start with Betty De La Cruz. 19 kills last night, top of the leaderboard. And we've talked about Auri Cruz and the impact she's made. A double-double last night in her most complete match of the season. And Taylor Sambothi, 8 kills, 320 points on the leaderboard. And how about Nutsara Tomcom getting all 5 hitters involved and leading her team to a 308 hitting percentage in last night's win.
Rosenthal's gonna be back at the line. Team De La Cruz coming off a 71-66 victory over Team Lickman. Team Valentin-Anderson along with Taylor Sambothi there and Val Nickel beat Team Drews 71-67. And out of the timeout, nothing has changed. It's 8-2.
Boy, and that's a rare misconnect between Valentin-Anderson and Shuh. We have seen them do very well in practice today. They were on all cylinders. Not so much so far tonight.
Our Geico leaderboard popping up live there, and you will see it change as points are scored like that. Ari Shuh adds to her total 8 points for the kill.
Ari Shuh goes back to the service line, one of the best servers in the league, and I think a lot of people have been surprised at how effective she's been from the end line.
Well, Ari uses all of her height, 6'3", a long 6'3", and does a nice job extending. This thing is flat, and men's players out there, if you haven't ever passed on a women's net, total nightmare.
The comes ball at you so much faster.
And so flat at you all the time. It is brutal.
Yeah, definitely a lower trajectory, and the higher you are and the higher your point of contact, it can actually be coming down at you.
A couple of rehab stints. I was in town when the women were prepping to play Cuba or Russia. I was on the other side.
Nice.
Yeah. Cuban
the
game, strong.
Cuban player.
Yep. Right side. Off the block and just out of bounds, Kalei Mao with the kill. Let's check in with Key.
Hi, guys. I've got Matt here, coach at Oregon, and apparently there's a few ducks floating around here.
Duck versus duck right now.
Yeah?
Duck versus duck.
So we've got Benny and Veronica, right?
That's it. You got
you
it.
You coach both of them.
Both of them. Yeah.
Tell us something. Tell us something about each of them. I love them both, but.
Love them so much. Very different, but so competitive, both of them. I think that's something that makes them so successful, is they want to win at all costs, no matter what we're doing. Cards, anything, like they want to win.
Cards as well.
Yeah, and I'm the same way, so we have a lot of fun together.
Yeah? Well, seeing them here play against each other, we know they're friends off the court, we know they're former teammates. Who do you think's going to win?
They're both wonderful, and they're both winners in my heart, and I'm just so proud of each of them.
Oh, come on, Matt.
I know, Matt.
It's like telling me to pick my.
You're not gonna let me.
Like, which
one.
Kids are my favorite? You know, it's like no, they're all my favorite. Love
them. They're both your favorites in different ways.
That's right.
All right.
I bet Amanda digs more balls. I bet Veronica blocks more balls.
Oh, that's bold.
How's that?
That's a good one.
I feel good about that.
That's a great call. Yeah. I'm gonna second that. Well, just being here at Athletes Unlimited, you're a coach. You're at a high level. What is it like seeing this level of play and knowing that some of your players might end up playing here in the years to come?
Yeah, I was just telling someone, I think I've coached like 29 different professional players, and I've never seen any of them play live until right now.
Right.
And I think that's just, it's really just a really cool feeling just to be able to watch your players. And they just look like they're having so much fun. The amount of love right now that they're having playing volleyball and just being part of the team and being here in the U.S. and playing, it's just, it does my heart good to watch them just be so happy and just enjoying it.
I can actually concur because I met both of them when Benny was playing in Switzerland and when Monica was playing in France, and I've spoken to them since about having come back and played in the US, and they're both like, this is just beyond blown out my expectations. So I think you're right.
Yeah.
I think they're having a great time.
You know, and you got the family in the stands, and the Stones are crazy.
Yeah, they
are. Yeah. I think I need to go get one of the face ones.
Head. Yeah, the cardboard head.
I think I need to get that.
You need to get one. Well, thank you so much for being here. We'll get you two cardboard heads, one of Benny and one of Veronica, and then we'll be safe.
There you go. Thanks a lot.
Matt Ulmer is going to be dispatched on a diplomacy mission over the summer. Little known fact.
He is Switzerland. So neutral. I love it. Well played. But really cool, Kevin. We have had so many college coaches throughout the season here. And just to hear all of them talk about how Athletes Unlimited has changed the perspective. You know, they talk to their players now about their future and their goals and wanting to play professionally. And now having this domestic option has changed the game, has changed the goal setting for their current collegiate players for what they want to do next.
I know that's a huge part of the Athletes Unlimited brand is changing the narrative around female sports. It doesn't just stop after college. I think volleyball very fortunate to have had some options. This is just another great one. Sam Bothy covers herself. Veronica back the other way, and that is duck past duck.
So the
this
big
is
question.
Both Matt Ulmer's favorite and least favorite play.
Yeah, did Matt Ulmer teach Veronica Stone how to do this and then nail Benny, teammate to teammate? Love it.
Double block there, but it still finds its way, the ball right down the front of it. A drubbing of a first set thus far.
And a great set for start for Veronica Stone. And it's been fun to see when players, former college coaches have come to watch. They've really, you can tell there's a little extra juice in their step. We saw that with Leah Edmond earlier tonight and her coach Craig Skinner in the house. Very cool.
All right, Cruz herself, an Olympian and a huge part of this quick start for Team Dela Cruz, was excellent last night, and they are once again carrying excellence. 14-5, they lead Team Dela Cruz. And we'll hear more from Bethany Dela Cruz about the love for her mother who put her on this path.
Her because she was alone with two child because my dad died when I was just one, my big brother 7, and I can imagine how difficult for her was this moment. And she worked, she did everything, she gave her best for us, and I think she is the best.
What an international career Bethany Dela Cruz has built on the strength of her mother.
Yeah, and now Betty is passing that down to her son, Fair, an amazing mom and role model to her 12-year-old son who's been here in Dallas the entire time. There's a good look at Fair. Now known as Famous Fair, doing online schooling back home to the Dominican Republic, and all of his friends very envious of all of his TV time.
I don't think he's in science class right now. He has been enjoying the entirety of Athletes Unlimited. Did not make the trip last year. Overhead, there is Bethania. Nickel leaves it, dug by NBA. Out of the back row, Cruz is sent back. Taylor Morgan. We wondered if we might see Taylor Morgan in the middle.
Yeah, and this is a great substitution. I mean, they needed a spark, they needed a sub, and Taylor Morgan doing exactly what you do when you're called upon from the bench, and that is make a difference and fire your team up.
Tamo in. How about the captain putting herself on the sideline? Val Nickel in full time. A service there from Belines with the hybrid.
Yeah, Natalia Valentin-Anderson not wasting any time going to the bench and making some changes. They are hitting negative right now as a team, and that's why.
For every ace this season, Aspiration is planting 10 trees. Heading into tonight, 1,900 trees have been committed thanks to Aspiration's support. Out of the ace comes an error.
I talked about the fact that Valentin-Anderson hitting negative as a team. Team De La Cruz, exactly the opposite. Coming out to a blistering 750 to start this match.
Ooh, that is a blistering number. Nice move by Stone. Betty trying to chip it off, didn't work. How about again? Yeah, a little more power behind that one. Remember, not only are they setting themselves up for a possible big victory in the first, but a commanding lead in the overall.
Absolutely. I mean, this is a huge start, exactly what team captain Betty De La Cruz wanted, and she's doing everything she can to help her team out. Four kills already for the captain.
Stone serves Benson, stalls her. That was a crisp contact.
It's amazing to me to watch Lindsay Stalzer play and think she has been a professional volleyball player for 16 years. She graduated from Bradley in 2006. And to see the pop that she has and the athleticism and the vertical, it's just stunning and awesome.
There she is again, second line shot, knowing that Nutsara is out there.
Just makes you appreciate how well she's taking care of herself, and I mean, just the epitome of fitness and athleticism. Beautiful arm swing, sees the seam and takes advantage of hitting right over the top of Tom Com.
An outstanding artist as well. She underplayed that in Key's off-season spotlight. Go ahead and check that out at AU Pro Sports YouTube channel. He visited with a bunch of different athletes, including Taylor Morgan and Lindsay Stalzer, among others. And she was a mechanical engineering major. Like, I asked her last year, really, mechanical engineering? You worked that hard to do this?
It's so cool that, like, artist and mechanical engineering, like, both sides of the brain, like, the whole package.
And jumps, like, 38 inches.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool.
It's a good thing she's nice. Otherwise, she'd drive us all nuts because she's perfect.
Stalzer again, this time high into the hands. Her Valines in the back. Valines provided some much-needed balance last night. Tamo in at that opposite. Good pop-up by Nickel. Stalzer not afraid, but the wall of Rosenthal is there.
I was watching Jenna Rosenthal warm up before this match and doing all of her blocking warm-ups, and it's just incredible to see the way she uses her 6'5" frame. I mean, she's obviously got the height, but she's also got the technique. I mean, it is a lethal combo.
Morgan right off someone's face. I would venture to say that was Rosenthal's.
Yeah, based on her reaction, I would agree. So now Valentin-Anderson back in as a back row setter, replacing Val Nickel, who played across the front row. Val Nickel, a much taller setter at 6'1". Provides more of a block in the front row.
That ball might have been out, played anyway. Betania, no approach. Lindsay versus Beth. That ball is still going. Valentin-Anderson has used both of their timeouts.
This is a great point scoring rotation for Team De La Cruz. Betty at the service line. This comes at you so fast. Topspin jumper, a traditional old school jump serve, high velocity and drops.
Benson with a sprawl, got it. Betty, big crack. Both setters playing defense. No Morris, outstretched. Betty overhand dig. Nothing there in transition. Shuh with the kill. Ari Shuh collects it. That's a lot of work for 1 point.
Our show running a quicker offense than we've seen up until now. I think that the communication getting better between she and Valentin-Anderson.
Rosenthal sweeps it. Ari, big approach. Yeah, she's been feeling fresh. A little too fast to the outside that time. Calais. Dug by Benson. Another long rally here. Blinds. High hands winner.
That's a big swing by Madison Valines. We've seen so much of Stalzer, but Stalzer rotates to the back row, which brings in Madison Valines as the L2 and does a great job getting the assist from her outside teammate going high hands against that big Rosenthal block.
Madison Valines already with 9 attempts. That is good for the women in blue. Remember, it was 20 attempts for Lindsay Stalzer in just the first set.
Right. But then they got Valines involved.
Right.
Valines was a non-factor in the first set last night, and then they started realizing, okay, we need to set both of them, have some balance, and that made the difference in the match to me.
That ball was in. Ari misses it, was looking for some hands, didn't find them, but it all started with the serve.
Great deep ball serve by Stalzer, going for the end line, and they actually want to challenge that, see if there was a touch on Howard Cruz's attack.
Why not? We're at 19 points, haven't seen a challenge yet. Remember, two captain's challenges per team per set. You can challenge a variety of things, net or block, touch, all manner of line faults, ball in or out. And we've seen all of them this year.
Absolutely. Meanwhile, they can take this as a little bit of a timeout. So there's a definite touch there.
Yeah.
I think they might be challenging Ari Cruz's swing.
Right, that was the end of that rally there.
Now here's Ari's swing. Oh, that looked like it went over the top of the hands from that angle.
Yeah, it looked pretty clearly over the top of the block. But in any case, long rally. Chance to get the bottles out and relax a little bit.
Talk a little strategy. Catch your breath.
Key Michael perked up. She heard the word bottle, and she was flashing back to our conversation with Tina Bowe.
All right, see if there's a change of direction of the ball or if there's a finger movement at all from Erica Wilson. Middle finger, right hand. I don't think, ooh. Boy, it's as close as you can get.
What a job by our crew to get that shot there for you at home, as well as the referees and the players in the stadium who were all looking at the same thing.
I don't think they got it.
Detailed the rules for you earlier. If you prefer reading, there they are.
And they've called no touch. Ball to team Valentin-Anderson. You get two challenges per set, use it or lose it. And I like it. We see a lot of them use it late when they're out of timeouts and they need to stop a momentum.
Perfect pass by Ari. Everybody up. What happened there?
Yeah, I love the double quick.
Boy, the X1 would have been good. Instead, it's Rosenthal with another stuff. Second of the set.
I love the idea. They weren't able to execute that time, but on a perfect pass, you're running that double quick is going to score you a point more often than it's not.
Seven-point lead, set number one. Missed. Valentin-Anderson has cut into it a bit here. They were really out of shape at 16-7.
Well, they're hitting a lot smarter. They were hitting negative in the first part of this set. They've gotten into the positive territory and making smarter swings.
Thank you, our official partner Geico, for their support of Athletes Unlimited. Betty driven to the corner and then put away by Sam Bothy. How do you spell Sambothi in emoji? Fire, fire, fire.
I like it. She is the human emotion. Like, if you need somebody to bring a little heat, a little emotion out there, you want Sambothi on your court.
A little spice. Another overpass. And yes, sock puppet for that one.
Sambothi has been the queen of the overpass this week. You've got to give a lot of credit to this rotation because it's Shaw that's serving. The tough serve sets up the perfect puppet sock. Sock puppet.
I love it.
Something like that, right?
Yeah, you got it. All right. Love it. Yeah, either
I'm
way.
I'm learning from you, Kevin.
It's all made up anyway. Right side, miss from Mao. And look at this. Two timeouts burned by Valentin-Anderson. The second was at 14-5. They have completely reversed the flow of momentum here in the first set. Is now 20-17, and Team Dela Cruz is calling a timeout.
And Kevin, give some credit to the captain, Natalia Valentin-Anderson, for not waiting too long and immediately when things were going south at 14-5, making substitution changes, bringing in Val Nickel, bringing in Taylor Morgan to change the dynamic on the court.
Well, let's go into the action with guaranteed rate right now with Val Nickel.
We love. Same thing, sets back three, go gap red. Back row. Nope. Yes! Let's go. I think we're going to need them off a lot tonight. Sets back, they're stacked, they're stacked. Watch slide one, go. Here we go, slide. Yeah! Let's go. Good job.
That was into the action with Ronica Stone and her normal-sized head.
We heard Matt Ulmer, her college coach, talk about the Stone family and all the fire they bring. There's a large-sized Ronica head.
Yeah, Ronica off to another nice start here. What a star she has been. Two kills on four. That'll do. You want to get into the ball a little bit more.
I'd be happy hitting 500.
That is the biggest of fatheads I've seen. Looking back at Ronica's numbers last night, 9 kills on 13, one error. That is 6-15.
And that'll get you moving up on the Geico leaderboard for sure. De La Cruz still with a commanding lead.
And Drew's just above Valentin-Anderson for the moment, but that will be changing, no doubt, in this match. Dana Drew's already completed her match tonight, a loss to Team Lickman 68-65. Team Lickman nearly with the sweep, lost the third set 25-18. Could have been a very different story. A big comeback in the second set came up just short for Team Drews.
Yeah, but big that they at least got the set three leaderboard points to keep Drews in that hunt for second or third.
Yeah, and the person who had to be happy about that was Bethany De La Cruz, who extended her lead last night over Danny Drews. And with a victory here, could really nearly seal up the title headed into Saturday and her impending coronation.
Right now they're looking for serve receive. Team De La Cruz needs a good pass. Allow TomCom to run a sophisticated offense. That ball might have been out.
It matters not if you go high hands.
How about the start that Ari Cruz is having, picking up where she left off last night. 5 kills now on 10 swings.
And 5 good kills too. A lot of pop, a lot of pace.
Absolutely playing the best volleyball of the season right now. I think she's feeling healthy, energized.
Tori Dilfer in to serve. That one caused confusion. Don't put that one in the passing manual. The left-handed throw of the dice.
That's one of those where the coach starts yelling until they see how beautiful the pass was. Creating one-on-one, big seam in the block for Valines to go right into the middle of the court.
Stalzer threw some boxcars right there. Did it fall? It did not. 22-18. So this set is going to end up looking fairly competitive, even though early on it was not.
See Team De La Cruz, all three blockers going to position. Tom Kahn will go to the left of your screen, the right side on the court, the natural setter position to block.
The line's second swing. Cruz lunges in front. Here's Bethania. Maddie rolls shot, the soft touch. Her beach chops from Arizona.
Nice change of pace by the lines. The last attempt we saw with all the power, so the defense is dug in, expecting more heat, and at the last second, the roll shot.
Ooh, the heater from Betty.
Boy, what can't Betty do? It is so much fun watching her game. Such a great leader and just like a calm, poised presence and just so consistent. Consistently great.
Working to Stalzer, she pulls it up nice and high. Backslide Sambothi is dug. Betty with essentially nobody.
And it all starts with the dig by Ari Cruz to keep that transition alive.
First set point for Team De La Cruz. Nutsara with the closer. You know things are going well when your setter picks up the stuff for the set win. A 6-point lead headed to the second. 40 team points secure. De La Cruz all golden in the first.
Team De La Cruz with the 25-19 set one win behind its captain, Betty De La Cruz, with 6 kills, hitting 500, making an impact in the front row and here in the back row. Great transition play and showing just her true power on the outside. Such a heavy shoulder and so consistent. And now Betty De La Cruz with 203 kills becomes the 4th player in Athletes Unlimited history to reach 200. Jordan Larson's done it, Karsta Lowe, Danny Drews did it in the match earlier tonight, and then now Betty De La Cruz, the 4th to 200.
Players often say they don't want the individual accolades. It's an individual title, so you're looking for that accolade coming up. And it is an individual title because the CEO and co-founder, John Patrickoff, who's with Key.
Yes, I've got John Patrickoff, but I feel like I've got so much more than that.
Who's back?
I've got Jonathan Sars and Cassidy and your whole crew.
We got everybody. Everybody's here tonight.
It's
a big weekend here in Dallas.
It is. Season 2 of Athletes Unlimited Volleyball. I've been waiting for this for a long time. What about you? What's different for you this year?
I mean, it's incredible. I mean, most importantly, having fans in the building has just been awesome. It adds so much energy, adds so much excitement, and getting to see people come in from all around the country. I mean, obviously, Dallas, Texas, huge, huge volleyball community, but seeing people come in from all over the country, all over the world, actually, to watch the action, this has been awesome.
And do your daughters play volleyball?
Chloe's played some volleyball. Lila's going to start playing volleyball, so we're making it a whole family affair.
Love that. You got to choose volleyball, guys. I know you could choose from softball, lacrosse, basketball, but volleyball, that's the way to go.
He's a little biased.
I'm a little bit biased. But speaking of softball, softball's coming up. AUX?
Absolutely. So excited. I mean, we have a huge summer ahead for Athletes Unlimited. We're going to launch AUX softball in San Diego. That's our new 2-week version of the Athletes Unlimited format. It's going to be incredibly exciting, really compressed, intense season. And then we roll into lacrosse and softball, season 3 of softball, season 2 of lacrosse. It's going to be terrific. Tickets are on sale now for softball, so I encourage everyone to go. And it's so great. I just want to say, one of our fans who's been to all 4 sports, actually 3 of our 4 sports, was here tonight again in Dallas visiting. So seeing fans come from Chicago to Las Vegas, now to Dallas, and he's talking about coming this summer to La Crosse. So it's just awesome to see, and we're just excited for all that lies ahead.
That's what's been one of my favorite parts, now having been at basketball, back to volleyball, and I'm looking forward to going to softball. Hopefully it feels so good to just be part of the AU family.
It is. That's the connection points that we're trying to build between athletes across sports, between athletes and fans, the entire community. I mean, today, this week obviously was a huge week for us with the release of our public benefit corporation report, but also our first stakeholder meeting, which was awesome. We had fans, partners, employees, all on the call together, athletes all kind of talking about what we're doing at Athletes Unlimited, what we're about, taking questions, and that's what we're trying to do, build a really unique community in pro sports and hopefully model that kind of behavior for other organizations.
And I love that it all just sparked between, it was an idea between you and Jonathan just sitting, talking about what could be. And now that it's here in fruition, you're literally sitting on the sidelines. I mean, the volleyball's right there. Does it feel as cool as you imagined it?
It feels as cool as I imagined it. But the truth is, we started out with some early ideas. But I said on that call this week, on the stakeholder call, I said, really when things really took off was in November of 2019 when we met with the first of our softball players. And we started to realize how powerful it would be to partner with the athletes across the board. We got Cassidy back here, who's not only an amazing player and climbing the leaderboard, but also on the chair of the player executive committee, but also sits on the board of Athletes Unlimited. And you know, that's a huge, unique statement. She brings so much, but so do all the other players that are part of this community. And you know, I think this makes us so much stronger.
Well, thank you so much for giving us the opportunity to be players and to be part of something really like bigger than us. It's
well,
awesome.
Thank
Thanks,
you.
Guys.
And I can't wait to see everyone in San Diego. AUX this
June.
Diego. Don't miss it.
AUX in June. We'll be wrapping here tomorrow night.
You can tell how much these players have loved this season. When talking to them this morning at their practice, every single person I talked to said, I cannot believe it's coming to an end. It's gone so fast, and it's going to be so bizarre come Sunday to fly home after I've been, you know, with 44 amazing athletes and to suddenly have it be over. I mean, everybody is really sad that this season's coming to an end.
It's not dissimilar from an Olympics. It takes about 5 weeks of an athlete's time usually, maybe about six if you're on your way in and out. Coming up June 13th to June 25th, that will be softball AUX. That will be in San Diego. Then lacrosse season 2, July 21 through August 14. And softball season 3, July 29 to August 28th.
I love it that we get a double dip of softball.
Yeah, go to auprosports.com/tickets and start planning. Taylor Sambothi and crew are going to try and plan for a second set victory. They did a nice job stabilizing in the first. They still hit 9% for the set. But they're not that far back. They're only trailing by five.
And while Key was talking to John, Taylor Sambothi just took over. There she is in the middle of the court patrolling. Watch her go side to side. The lateral movement to get up and block. Gets that touch.
Benson, some quick feet to get that second contact. Rosenthal stretches out. And Cruz got there way too early. The defensive level this year has most certainly been raised. If you look at the all-time digs in a set, Hannah Lishman put up 22 last night, and four of the top six have been in this season alone.
Absolutely fantastic. We saw Morgan Hentz get 20, Kirsta Lowe with 21.
Miss there from Wilson. Opposite position, something to watch here. Players that are being asked to do something that they haven't in a while. Erica Wilson last night had six kills and added a service ace. On the other side, I mentioned earlier, Kalei Mao was off offensively. So watch both those players. It's 44 in gold. And on the far side, 26 in blue.
Unfortunately, Athletes Unlimited has had some injuries this season and a lot of them to the opposite position. So like you said, people getting thrown into positions. Kalei Mao, typically an outside hitter, played outside at Arizona and showing her versatility and flexibility, filling in on that right side. Very different as a hitter to hit from the left side versus the right.
I always enjoyed opposite. Freed me from the business of passing.
Having to pass because yeah. You just wanted to hit.
Yeah,
your very simple needs, right?
Yeah, like an alligator, except playing volleyball. Just a basal creature.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You may ask, what's the difference from the left to the right? Well, imagine you're a right-handed attacker and you're swinging on the left side. You're opening your body to the court so you can see the ball coming at you and you can see the entire court. If you're on the right side as a righty, you're opening your body and turning your back to the court, which makes it a lot harder to see the ball and the defenders. Exact opposite if you're a lefty, which is why you see a lot of lefties playing on the right side.
5-4 second set. That was Heather Cox. I'm Kevin Barnett. You saw Key Michael moments ago, the Olympian, patrolling the sidelines for us. And we are in our second match of a Friday night. We are really down to it here. Two more matches coming up for you tomorrow evening. And then Athletes Unlimited Volleyball Season 2 will be in the history book.
You want to serve here or here? Keep the ball away from the libero.
Serve Betty Tough. Sambothi can't quite get there.
And really, when I draw those circles, I shouldn't draw them on the player. I should draw them on the gaps between the players, because so many coaches will tell you to serve an area. And what happens is, as a server, you go and you look at the player instead of the open space, and you really want to serve the open space.
Here's Ari Cruz looking for some open space. Instead, it's right at Stalzer. Perfect pass. And what a play by Tori Dilfer. Back again. That one had some backspin on it. That would have laid up right next to the cup if you let it hit. A little cleanup. You heard Ronica Stone earlier saying we're going to need those mops.
All right, so here's the areas you want to serve. Deep corner, back there. You want to keep it away from Velez Agosto. Oh, they got it to her, but now Betty's wide open to swing. Didn't have to worry about passing. So often you're seeing people serve the top offensive threat when they're in the front row. So instead you want to serve Betty, force her to pass, maybe even get her on the ground, and then force her to get up and have to swing.
When Betty gets in the air, if you can hit the B button three times, you get turbo. That's what you just saw. Very show with the kill, and Team Valentin-Anderson holds on to that two-point advantage. Valentin-Anderson lost the first set last night, came back and won the next two for the overall victory.
Nice job, show going one-on-one with Jenna Rosenthal. Key to that, keeping the ball in front of you so you can see those blockers' hands.
A service, key to that, hit the cable and have it slow down. 9-6. Keep in mind the importance of this for Natalia Valentin-Anderson. Going to be in second place after this, but how close will she be to Betania de la Cruz? Oh, that is the slowest kill on record in AU volleyball history.
And everybody, I mean, you've got six players, well, five in gold, one in black, but all six of them, hands up in the air like, what happened? How in the world did that happen? You're right, that is the slowest kill in history. I mean, that was slower than a free ball.
Betty doesn't know what happened.
Yeah. Why?
My people. Jenna, just inside of the lines. Substitution back, Kalei Mao back into the front row.
You'll see Kalei, number 44, go to the left side of your screen, the right side of the court. Betty will go in the opposite direction so that they can block their positions.
Big block, Jenna Rosenthal. Back to within two, come the gold.
Jenna just patrolling the net, three blocks now. Watch her eyes. They go to the setter, the ball, and then the hitter's shoulder. Great eye work. And then the penetration with the hands to seal it.
The Lions powers it right through. That ball's still good.
How is that legal?
Yeah, soccer play again from Mao. Doesn't matter. Good job by Valentin-Anderson to keep playing.
And I like the balance that we're seeing tonight, Kevin, between Lindsay Stalzer and Madison Valines. All right, take a look. But that, whoa, that hit her three different times.
It certainly did. There's the old one motion thing.
I'm not sure I'm good with that.
It's the one motion. Spectacular play claws, both piled on top of each other. Betty tip. Not enough room there. Valentin-Anderson sliding in.
The Sambothi hands. Little back set with the hands from your middle. Look at Val Neckel, who's a setter. It's like, whoa, where did that come from?
Sambothi is not afraid.
No.
Not of you or a back set.
She has never met a play she didn't like. If you need it, I'll do it.
Timeout called at 12-8. A reversal. Valentin-Anderson stiffened in the first. They have gone ahead in the second.
The whip, drop, the nene, the milli rock, and all the dances. I love TikTok. I think it's just a way people can be creative with no judgment. I've gone viral a couple times. Me and two of my other teammates used to make dancing videos before games. We were called the Big Three. And so we made a lot of dancing videos, and then senior year, they both had graduated. And so I was making dance videos by myself, and I made up a dance, and it got over 3 million views. Like here, and then.
How are your moves, Heather?
Not good at all. I can't play that game, but it's crazy. 3.8 million views on TikTok. It's a whole different world.
Indeed it is. Ronica Stone out of Oregon.
On still, cue.
Still having a good time here, yeah. Look at our Geico leaderboard. Bethany De La Cruz in control. Valentin-Anderson chasing. Would want to take this set away from Bethany.
You have any TikToks going viral?
No. High blast. Ari Cruz with the hands. Betty again. Lot of open court. And that ball called out. You might see a challenge here. Betty questioning.
Real time, I thought it was out, but yep, let's take another look.
And Betty makes one of the seven signs for a challenge.
Tap your head, draw a TV, put up a C.
Yeah.
Yell challenge.
I had it in real time, but I don't have a great angle on it going away from me.
Ooh, oh, that looks really in.
Yeah. Heather, you're minus 12. I'm going plus 12. That's a 24-point swing.
Yikes.
Can't wait to write my name in the Book of Unlimited. That was a quick challenge. But you don't keep them, so you got to use them. One challenge remaining. Bethania, she's been hitting that ball hard, tailing away. That would be the Stalzer's left. This is maybe an ideal lineup for her. Bad pass. The lines. Way over the block and out of bounds.
And this is definitely a rotation to keep track of. This is a weak rotation for Team Valentin-Anderson and a strong one for De La Cruz. So how quickly can Valentin-Anderson rotate out of it? Starts with a good pass against, I think, the toughest serve in the league. Watch this coming at you. It's usually around 50 miles an hour. Tons of top spin, so it drops underneath you. That's a good pass.
Wilson blasting through.
And big move by Erica Wilson, rotating the team out of that serve-receive pattern. You see TomCom calling the plays. Setters will call three plays to all their hitters every single serve receive. So if you're wondering what all those hand signals are, they're code for all the different sets you can hit.
You're in the ceiling of Fair Park. A little confusion between TomCom and De La Cruz. Wilson mishandled that one. And a very similar looking swing from Belines. Can't catch the hands.
And that's the Jenna Rosenthal impact. When she's in the front row and you're swinging, you see them going high hands a lot because they are definitely not wanting to get stuffed.
6'5" women's player, roughly equivalent to a 7-foot tall men's player. Backslide, Betty with the dig right on top. Outside. Cruz, nobody up. Winner, winner.
Chicken dinner. 7 kills now for Ari Cruz, hitting over 200 right over the block. There's a lot of miscommunication on that block. It almost looks like Zambothi. Oh, yeah, they kind of run into each other. Valentin-Anderson caught. Doesn't get to the outside.
Rosenthal again from the line, looking for the tie in this set. Valentin-Anderson got enough of it as it wrapped over the cable. Line shot, winner.
I like the balance we're seeing from the pins for Team Valentin-Anderson. You look at Lindsay Stalzer, she's got 15 swings. Madison Valine with 22. It was absolutely the other way around last night. And once they started getting Valine's more involved, they got better and better.
Valine's involved defensively now. Stalzer through the block and down. They extend their lead to 3.
Stalzer are calling out how many hitters? 3 hitters across the front row.
Cruz trying to tool Valentin-Anderson. Another tough collision there. We have seen the defense raise its level for sure, but we've seen our share of pretty rough collisions.
Valentin-Anderson with the touch. Both of them going for it. I'm glad that neither one of them hit heads, but definitely.
I love the tracking from the blocker, Valentin-Anderson there. Off the block, up over her head.
Yep.
That save is just out of bounds. Still with a 3-point lead. But down in the set, here comes Tori Dilfer.
I like the way that Betty De La Cruz is using Tori Dilfer, having her come in the back row for Kalei Mao. She will serve and then go play right back. She's a trained setter, so she can be that second setter as well.
2-time ACC setter of the year. I would like to have seen her set one weekend.
Absolutely.
Dig there from 38. Cruz with a head of steam.
Boy, have I been impressed with what we've seen out of Ari Cruz this week. Last night, a double-double with 12 kills. Watch the dig. It starts with Tori Dilfer in perfect position. Great reflexes to get that ball up. And then Nusara Tomcom, I think the best bumping setter there is. And Ari Cruz gets that sharp cross court.
Challenge issued as to whether the ball is in or out. Our second challenge of the set. First for Valentin-Anderson. I had it in live play.
I did as well.
So we're going up or down together right now, Heather.
All right, take a look. If it touches any of the white, oh, that's in by
that's
a mile.
It. Yeah, we're taking a timeout at this point.
Time for water, towel down, talk a little strategy. This ball is in.
Temperature and humidity climbing in Dallas over the last 24 hours. A much warmer evening inside Fair Park.
Watch how Cruz gets right inside the hands of Zambothi. That ball is in.
And the call is confirmed. So we'll stay 39-35. Amanda Benson, one of the finalists for the Geico Defensive Player of the Year. $5,000 go along with that award, and you can hear who wins it, who takes home the big check. And our closing ceremonies immediately following the conclusion of tomorrow night's final match. Stalls are way up high. Big Beth with the dig. Cruz pushes it down the line. It's good.
Kevin, you were talking about the Geico Defensive Player of the Year. Kind of cool. There are 3 liberos and 1 setter. Natalia Valentin-Anderson up for that award and so well deserved. Has been incredible defensively. Here's a look. We've got libero Morgan Hentz, who had over 20 kills earlier tonight. Amanda Benson, Namara Velez-Augusto, and the setter.
Batania, another dig. Ari, another put away. This time it's tipped the other direction. savvy veteran plays.
Absolutely. I mean, all right, Cruz is, you know, she was an amazing player at the University of Florida. Got to give the assist to Betty De La Cruz getting that dig up. Then, of course, played for Puerto Rico in the 2016 Olympics. And you can see why. She's just so consistent. I love this lineup for Betty De La Cruz. I really think she surrounded herself with people like the perfect team for Betty on this final week of AU play.
De La Cruz has trailed for the majority of this set. In fact, for the entire set. Looking for the lead. They built a big one early in the first. This has been a struggle. Dill for another dig. Cruz. Betty playing over the small block. Nice job. And Cruz with another transition kill. All right, Cruz, MVP one right now. If it
absolutely
ends.
Just feeling it. And how about Betty De La Cruz with the dig two, reading behind her shorter setter. All cylinders right now for Team De La Cruz.
Talked about the night that De La Cruz had last night. It was 12 kills, something to be excited about. She already has 12, hitting 390. Her team up again.
We're talking about the Book of Unlimited. How do you feel about it, Gwen?
I love the way my name looks in it, that's for sure.
Yes!
The Book of Unlimited is where we record all of the history and all of the champions and all those who compete in Athletes Unlimited. It's hand-bound, it's leather-bound, it has 500 pages, so we have a few seasons to go. We're five seasons in, was made custom for us, it weighs over 25 pounds. The symbol of the hands, it is five elements that are the helping hands representing Athletes Unlimited.
And if you want to touch it, you have to wear gloves?
Peace.
All right, Andrew's just told me that if I put on some gloves, I can touch the book, so I'm excited! I might be the second or third person to touch it. All righty, here we go.
I've gotten that far.
The coolest thing about this is that the champion is yet to be written, so good luck, players. Go AU!
I would like it if Key had edited in the music there, but I'd like it even more that she did the music herself.
I love that. It's like the Stanley Cup. Have to have a glove on to touch it.
That's right. Welcome back to Fair Park Coliseum in Dallas, Texas. Kevin Barnett alongside Heather Cox. We are in set number two, match number two. Key Michael, who you just saw, is on the sideline. Lindsay Stalzer collects another kill there. We're tied at 17. First set was 25-19 in favor of De La Cruz. They controlled the action almost the entire time as we've gone to the dogs. That's it. It's happened.
Mark. I mean, we all want to see that, right?
Time.
Thank you, Key.
TOD, time of dogs, 10:16 on April 15th.
It's like baby storm. Squirrel, oh, look at the tongue, too. I mean, come on.
Yeah. Put that in the Book of Unlimited. Put your tongue in your mouth. It's national TV, my man. Sambothi, tough serve. And the dig. Stalzer, lefty, and avoids the ball off the block.
What a heads-up play. Somebody that hasn't played professionally for 16 years would not be able to get out of the way of this ball. Watch her tool the hands, but then it comes right back at her, and she has the presence of mind to get out of the way.
Timeout yields a little 3-0 run.
Boy, the 1-2 punch of De La Cruz and Cruz has been so impressive in this match. I mean, there's never a break for Team Valentin-Anderson. There is always a threat on the outside pin.
Betty, a little crossbody tip, finds the line. She knows the dimensions.
All right, so back here, you'll see Erica Wilson right here. She's out of the serve receive because as a right side player, she will patrol the backcourt and ideally go over here and hit a back row attack, just another offensive weapon. They take her out so she doesn't have to worry about passing.
Cruz shoots that one at the net a little too far and too hard. Ari Shook cleans it up.
Now with Valentin-Anderson rotating into the back row, that moves Erica Wilson into the front row and getting replaced by Taylor Morgan.
Morgan, a middle blocker, maybe looking for a little defense at the net here. Has some opposite experience. They go away from her, and instead, Ronica Stone hits a planetary ball, and it is out.
Great middle matchup right now with Ronica Stone and Arisha.
Would you go back to Ronica?
Absolutely.
Okay. Benson with the dig. How about Beth again? Rejected, covered by Cruz. Ball is tight.
Cruz is everywhere.
Morgan, welcome to the match. Betty pounds it through. Anderson. The block ends it. Ronica. 45-40, and Kalei Mao joins us.
Aloha.
Aloha, Kalei. What's happened on the gold side tonight? You guys were in good control, and then you faced a little bit of pressure.
Yeah, I think what I can tell you that's working for us is the defense, moving into spots and reading and just playing good defense around after these good outside hitters that are just jumping over blocks and hitting long and swinging hard. So that's pretty much what's working for us. If we can keep that up, we can probably close out soon.
Kalei, how motivated is this team to get it done for your captain, Betty De La Cruz, with a match and a half remaining?
Almost as motivated as we were for Shayla Castro on her last game. This is like sealing the deal for Betty. So this is awesome to play with.
You're playing on the right side, a little bit different for you.
Yeah.
What are the challenges you face moving from left to right?
Probably the timing. I'm trying to work out the red set with Nuut. But pretty much I think I'm getting good spots on the block so that our defense can do what they need to do behind me. And other than that, no other challenges besides maybe right back defense.
How impressed have you been with your outsides? The combination of Betty and Ari has been pretty much unstoppable tonight.
For sure. Well, Audi Cruz has been an idol of mine since I was like my first year playing volleyball. So it's amazing to play with her and see her have her normal rhythm. And then of course, Betty is just an all-out athlete and I just love being on the court with them.
You say that you've idolized Ari for so long. What have you learned from her getting to share the court with her?
Her patience with herself, and a lot of the time with Audi is that she will take note from her own mistakes and she will correct it. She will never do the same thing twice.
Thanks, Kalei. Good luck.
Thank you.
Thanks.
All right, up 22-21. Timeout Valentin-Anderson, and now we get a chance to check in with Key and some neighborhood pups.
This is my wonderful dog, Franklin, who likes to smell trash and eat bacon and booty scratches. I've had him since March 2020, so right when the pandemic hit, we found him roaming in LA and we fell in love.
This is my mom's dog. Her name is Bella Chandelier. She is 10 months old.
Say hi, Bella.
This is Reese, and he's 5. I got him when I was in Poland from a shelter.
They're my fur babies. Copper is 5. He's my OG, my first dog, first love. And then Chesney is 4, and they're besties.
Hi, everybody. This is Peanut the Poopy. You can follow him on Instagram. He is 5 years old, and he's a Chihuahua Papillon mix.
So this is Chaz. This is my baby.
He's excited, clearly.
He's a French bulldog. He's a quad.
And he's super snuggly, and he loves to get his butt rubbed. And, right, he might roll over, huh?
Oh, he might roll over, huh?
No? Okay, well, it's not gonna roll over for a second. Okay.
By far, Key's favorite day. By far. Oh, Keith Barnett has bought a dog while he's here. Good to see.
You knew about his three kids. You didn't know about the dog?
No, I didn't know he came to Dallas to pick up a dog and maybe a new recruit for the Air Force. Didn't know that. Keith Barnett, head coach at Air Force Academy and father of three, and his wife Jessica in downtown.
By the way, if you're wondering, the last name's the same. Yep, they're brothers, Kevin and Keith.
True story.
Played volleyball together. Keith, 4 years younger, right? Setter, yep. You were a hitter.
Yep, good combination.
You guys ever play doubles together?
We really never did. Wish we
you
had.
You should.
It just never overlapped, because by the time he was in college, I was going to professional ranks and playing overseas, and he was playing overseas, and I was kind of done. And yeah.
Now he's getting it done at the Air Force Academy.
Certainly is. Went from second assistant to first assistant to head coach and had a couple of really good years. Beat Colorado State for the first time in team history, and that goes back to 1983. We're making history here with the Book of Unlimited and so many players. But Donnie De La Cruz, north of 200 kills. Just the fourth player to do so. And her team now up, a little late push here in the second set. Morgan with the tip, trying to keep Valentin-Anderson in it here. All right, if you're Lindsay Stalzer, where do you serve?
Well, I think you've got a couple choices. One is to serve Betty De La Cruz, who's a front row hitter right now, so make her work. I think that's the best choice, because otherwise you've got Cruz or the libero. Great ball control players.
All right, well, they went to Noma.
Yeah.
Here's Betty again. I mean, she's really making her own way. Benson with the dig again. Trading blows. Little push and wipe. Valentin-Anderson, never give up. Was there a touch? Betty thinks there was. Indeed. Set point. It took him just one to close out the first set. They'll try and close it out here. Clay Mao returns to the front row. Nitsara Tomcom to the line. Nitsara's been hitting some tough serves and streaks. Newt with eight aces coming into the weekend. Added one last night. Can she add one here? Blinds down the line.
Boy, that was a beautiful swing. Madison of Blinds in rhythm.
Yeah, you have to close it now. If you're Team De La Cruz, you don't want to be in a back and forth with a Valentin-Anderson team that has proven capable of catching fire. They're going to need one right now. Sambothi in the front row, Valines and Morgan.
First strike opportunity, serve receive for De La Cruz.
Betty closes it down. So Bethania De La Cruz and her side will be looking for the sweep as we enter the third. 100 team points remain. Number one looking to add to her lead.
Athletes Unlimited Volleyball on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Guaranteed Rate and by Dick's Sporting Goods.
Tonight's match is presented by Geico. For bundling made easy, go to geico.com. 50-42 in the overall. Team De La Cruz looking at a magic number of 18 in the third set to close out the overall. Team Valentin-Anderson trying to become the second team to lose two, come back and win it in the third.
Some match highlights so far. Taylor Morgan coming in off the bench for Valentin-Anderson and making an impact. Gets the block here on Ari Cruz, proving to be one of the top two threats for Team De La Cruz. And how about Lindsay Stalzer getting her seventh kill, this time swinging over the top of Tom Kom. And then the 1-2 punch on the outside for Valentin-Anderson. Madison Valines hitting 320, 12 kills that time off the Stalzer chicken wing. And then back to De La Cruz. It's a block party for Jenna Rosenthal. Drops in on the seam. Three blocks so far for Jenna. And I can't say enough about the job that Auri Cruz is doing. This time off the dig from her captain, Betty De La Cruz, goes over the top, 13 kills, hitting 420. And then, of course, it's Betty De La Cruz with the dig, the transition, the back row attack off the hands. Here it is coming at you. 410 on 11 kills. When your outside hitters are both hitting over 400, you are having a good night. Betty De La Cruz and Auri Cruz doing just that.
Betty De La Cruz adding 11 digs to that as well as Team De La Cruz continues to out-dig Team Valentin-Anderson.
And look at the defense. Six blocks for Team De La Cruz over two for Valentin-Anderson. And then the hitting percentage, such a tell. That 320 as a team obviously helped by the outside hitters.
Championships won and lost at the pins. First two sets won at the pins by De La Cruz. Specifically the left pin. We're ready for the third. Key Michael is on the sidelines. The Olympian, hashtag Key Camp. Send her somewhere. Find someone to talk to in the arena.
It's been interesting, Kevin. This is a matchup of, as you mentioned, outside pins on the left. Not a lot of action on the right side with the offense, and not as much middle either. I mean, this is an outside dominant matchup.
Utsaro with the dig. Speaking of the outsides, here's Betty way off the net. Missed contacts on both sides. Someone's gonna gather it in. It'll be Betty. Good night.
Just add 12 more points to the leaderboard. Make that 8. You know what, with a hit this hard though, I gave her 4 extra.
Bonus. It's the special Heather bonus. But Dania had never played alongside Auri Cruz before last night. I think the league is probably thankful that hasn't happened.
Yeah, it was a great draft choice.
That throw is good.
Taylor Morgan, who did play some opposite in Athletes Unlimited, just a little bit though, is usually a middle blocker, but showing her versatility and also her court awareness, finding that deep corner.
Tight to the net, dump, NVA with the dig. Betty, tough swing. Another difficult one, couldn't wipe it. But Sambothi missed. I love that battle with Valines as Betty tried to wipe her and Valines' stiff left hand kept it from getting pushed out of bounds.
Yeah, the little joust at the net. And that's what I was talking about with how difficult it is as a right-handed player swinging from the right side of the court. Those two swings from Betty De La Cruz, she's basically blind to the court and the block.
She's not blind on this play. Full vision for the serve. Again, the same rotation where she has the right people in front of her. And there you go, an ace. Let's put some trees in the ground, shall we, Betty? Aspiration will commit 10 trees for every ace that has been served. We were at 1,900 coming into the night. We're right about 2,000 right now, thanks to Aspiration and their support of Athletes Unlimited, as well as Planet Earth.
This ball coming at you at over 50 miles an hour.
In again, back to back, that's 20 trees.
Thank you, Betty. This ball with a little bit less topspin than the first, coming in at 45 miles an hour.
She's gone on a couple of hot streaks in the last couple of weeks. Betty Boumbaye from the service line.
And that one definitely faster than 45 miles an hour. That one had massive amounts of topspin.
Lindsay Stalzer will go to the bench, be replaced by Noami Santos Lamb. So a turkey.
That last one coming in at 48 miles an hour. Let's see what Betty's got in store for this one.
Morgan gets him out of that rotation. It was 5-1.
Yeah, what a great pass by Santos Lamb and a clutch substitution by Captain Valentin-Anderson.
Got to make some moves when you're under duress. Trailing by 11 now in the overall, 55-44. Rosenthal, boy, a little contortionist work there.
Yeah, that set was way too low for her 6'5" frame and her very long reach. She found a way. Watch Rosenthal's arm. She just sneaks it right through. It's about, I'd say, a foot lower than she wanted it to be. Finds a way.
Betty behind her kind of holding her breath. Backslide the other way. Rosenthal with the pause, high ball. See that on the shores of Lake Michigan. Again, coming to the Waupaca boat ride. Santos Lamb with the dig, how about a swing? Nope, free ball coming, that's long.
Ouch. So now what do you do if you're Jenna Rosenthal? I think you serve Santos Lamb. You're frustrated at yourself for just making a mental error. Free ball out, serve middle back.
I think you sneak it over. The last one nearly missed. You got lucky that somebody played it. That might have been long. Betty lunges. Calais finishes. 8-2. Timeout. Natalia Valentin-Anderson starting to look like set number one. Valentin-Anderson is going to need to recapture that energy.
I'm so clogged. I can't hear like anything. I got you deep. I know it sucks, but at least we came back from like 3 to 11. So now we can start that way. Yes! Let's go! Are you going big? I can go C too. We can have multiple. It flies like right at you, so you're like, maybe? Good job. Let's go. Let's get everything up here, yeah?
You are into the action with Guaranteed Rate and Madison Valines, hoping for another rally here in set number three. Let's find out who Key has come across.
I found Colt. This is Naki's husband. And you know the first question I'm going to ask you is how you guys met.
We were both in the same class at FIU. I played football, she played volleyball. And I definitely noticed her early. You know, we as football players went to every home volleyball game. Mm-hmm. She was this little firecracker out there with enough energy for both teams, with hair down to her tailbone. And then really that spring, we hung out with the same friends and started talking. What was funny though, we had two interactions the first semester there. I think I gave her a ride to our academic center and then once in the elevator. And, you know, I was talking a little game to her and she was laughing at everything I had to say. Come to find out, she didn't speak any English at the time.
So you thought you were the funniest really guy in class, and yet she didn't understand anything.
Not a word. Not
what a
word.
Sweetheart, though, to make you feel comfortable.
She did. She did.
You know what? Love is it's a language, but it doesn't have to be necessarily English. So getting to see her here, it's awesome, right?
Oh, it's everything. You know, we've been married 3 years together, almost 11, and I've followed her all over the world. And a lot of times her family and friends haven't seen her play. So to have a league here, I mean, it means everything.
So I actually played against her in France. So we might have even met before.
I would have remembered.
Appreciate you. Yeah. What do you guys get up to? You like to do a little salsa dancing, you told me.
Well, her mom actually taught me a little bit here.
True. Parents are right behind us.
Yeah, no, we like to dance. She's a phenomenal dancer. I like to think I can dance a little bit. So, yeah, definitely love dancing at free time.
And is she as much of a firecracker off court as she is on court?
Oh, 100%. 100%. Everything in life. She brings that energy.
Love that. And you guys, you also told me she likes to get a little DIY, likes to build houses. You buy houses and then get it.
Yeah, we flip houses. She likes to furnish them for me, pick the colors and whatnot. So she's my assistant when she's in town with the real estate stuff.
I can totally understand that. I geek out on a little bit of HGTV. Well, thank you so much for being on the broadcast. Tell us a little bit about Nati and her lovely smile.
Absolutely.
And her laughter.
Thanks for having me.
Key's next job. She's going to be manning the roller down there.
Just a little DIY.
Yeah, she's got into it. She said that my dad and my sister do DIY while I'm by the pool. And then she went home from last year's AU and she's like, I fully was into DIY.
Nice.
Like, redid everything at our place.
The very talented Key Michael.
Yep. And nice to hear from Colt there. So here we go, 8-4. A little bit of work left to do for Natalia.
Oh.
How about that delivery?
That play from start to finish was a thing of beauty. I mean, what about Tom Com's block to set up Ronica Stone to be wide open? Take a look at the perfect pass. It all starts with the perfect pass from Cruz, and then look at Tom Com turn her back. So deceptive. Little back one-foot takeoff by Stone. Just a thing of beauty from start to finish.
That'll keep a middle going, too. If you start delivering balls in off situations and weirdo spots, it will keep going. That'll get a setter going. Another block from 88.
Wow, she's doing it all. It's our Tom Com. Has been a professional volleyball player since she was 17 years old. 5'7", so athletic, and such a leaper. Started playing volleyball when her older sister started playing, and then her older sister was her first coach. Over 1 million followers on social media for Tom Com.
Dilfer issues up the ace. Things going from bad to worse for Valentin-Anderson. Magic number is 18. That would give them the overall victory. The lead right now is 7. Sambothi, big split offense, can't get the kill there. Noma, scoop to Ari. That was a lightning bolt. One more time. Blocked! Both setters now getting in on it. Natalia this time.
Team Valentin-Anderson looking for a little energy, a little spark, and a play like that will do just that. Now can they go on a mini run? Every point counts. All starts with a tough serve. Take De La Cruz out of system, make them predictable so you can get up a good block.
Yeah, I mean, you took Betty to the ground, and unfortunately for them, it just doesn't matter. That 1-2 punch you talked about.
Yeah, they've
been international stars.
Unstoppable. Auri Cruz now with 14 kills. Betty De La Cruz with 12. Both of them hitting over 350.
That is a prescription for success.
Throw in a little Ronica Stone, a little Jenna Rosenthal, and you've got yourself the keys to victory.
Throw in some cowbell, and you can get Bruce Dickinson involved. Noami. Betty. Yeah, another one. 13-5.
When you start to wonder, will we see Lindsay Stalzer again? I think that it's a good call to bring her back out onto the floor. Subbed out when she was having some passing trouble.
No move there yet. Noami Santos-Lamb stays in. They went double sub last time and had some success in the first set when they trailed big. That was Val Nickel and Taylor Morgan.
Stalls are hitting negative. 7 kills. 9 errors, 31 swings, but a great ball control player, and we know what she's capable of offensively. Also has 6 digs.
Here comes Taylor Morgan anyway to the front row. She'll replace Wilson.
So front row setter for Team De La Cruz. Tom Com playing middle front. 3 attackers for Team Valentin-Anderson.
Overpass cleaned up by Ari. Harry with the kill, and they get one step closer. You'd like a few more of those. Thank our official partner, Geico, for their support of Athletes Unlimited Volleyball, our final Friday night. 2 to go on Saturday, and that will be matches 29 and 30. Betty looking for hands.
She got it.
Yeah, she did. Can't sell the celebration like you used to. You used to be able to sell that you didn't touch anything.
Right. Now those evil cameras catch it all.
Yeah. Oh, right in the chops.
And this is a regular substitution. I mean, Ronica Stone would always come out right now, and Namara Velez-Augusto comes in, but watch this, just right to the cheek.
Have you thought about borrowing a helmet from Jordan?
Look, she reads it. She's moving in the right direction. It just comes up a little bit higher than she was expecting. Yeah, her husband, NFL player, could definitely use shoulder pads, helmet.
Rosenthal misfires.
Fair checking in on Ronica. Fair, of course, Betty De La Cruz's 12-year-old son. He's been everywhere. He's like assistant coach on the bench. He's over watching the live stream. Saw him eating cake earlier.
Medical officer.
Checking in on the cheek.
I love the way Nuzara scoops that ball. Very unique. Crouches under it and pulls it across.
Yeah, just such an unusual delivery, both with her hands and her bump set. And she just holds that form for so long. But look at this veteran savvy. I mean, going with the deep corner open hand tip. Nearly impossible to stop.
Mao nearly hit that one, but it goes outside the antenna off the left hand. And that's the one questionable as to whether it's an ace. I think it should be counted as such. Unreturnable. But generally, if you get a second contact, that's not considered an ace.
Yeah. To me, that's the way it goes. Like,
right.
if somebody touches it once and nobody gets that second contact, that's an ace. I mean, that makes it black and white to me.
Many years ago, the Greek League tried if you served and there was no second contact, it was worth 2 points.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. People were flying into the stands to touch the ball. Oh, one good push deserves another.
Yeah, Taylor Morgan says, I saw what you did there, Betty. I got one right back at you.
A little playground volleyball going on. Yeah, that experiment lasted one season in the Greek
League. Yeah, I
believe it. That was the end of that.
I feel like if it touches the ground, like that, that's 2 points. Like,
okay.
You know, I like that more than not getting the second touch.
Okay.
So right now, Team De La Cruz talking about their serve-receive while things get cleaned up. So you've got Velez Augusto in the middle. Now, I think the target right here is you go after Betty De La Cruz. Make her work. Even though you've got Ari Cruz in the front row, get Betty dirty so she can't be a back row attacker. Check that, Betty in the front row. That serve receive even got me.
Right side, Betty. Through the block and down, finding every which way. 17, they are on the precipice of the overall victory. 1 point away. Team Dela Cruz. Fastest game on 2 feet brings the action Saturday at noon Eastern as the 16th ranked Boston University Terriers go head to head against the Loyola Greyhounds. Right here on CBS Sports Network, it's a dogfight. We have had a whole bunch of excellent volleyball play by the women in gold here tonight. They have been the aggressors. There have been moments for Team Valentin-Anderson in the blue jerseys, but not enough. Second chance here to close it out for Team Dela Cruz. That would be the overall, but not the set. Remember, it's the aggregate score that would carry them here. Looking for 60 team points for Betania Dela Cruz. And Rosenthal delivers. There it is. Now looking for the sweep is Team Dela Cruz.
Sarah Tomcom turns her back to the opponent so that when she's calling her sets, nobody can see him and scout him.
Deep serve, good pass. Sambothi with the kill.
Sambothi has been so effective, but I don't think we have seen enough of her to really be able to have the impact that she'd like to have. Taylor Sambothi now with 7 kills. When you look at the middle attack, I just think that they should go to him more. 7 for Shep and 7 for Sambothi.
Mao punches it through. A lead of 6, and I don't see Valentin-Anderson coming back from this right now unless they get the energy of the second set.
Especially with Tori Dilfer coming in to serve. Last time Tori Dilfer came in as a serving and defensive specialist, they went on a run. Now they're looking for the same spark from Tori right now.
Betty talking to Noma. That's a pretty nice back row right there. Noma with the dig. Betty outside. Sambothi cross body, and to your point, defense from Dilfer. Cruz going high hands. Aya had a touch there, but it was a miss. And Ari not arguing. Betania Dela Cruz has crossed 4,000 points for the moment. Sambothi, another back set. Beauty. Was there a touch? Nothing called.
And they will
have a challenge. Yep. There's Betty at 40 and a quarter. Make it 4:30.
So the question is, did Noami Santos Lam get the touch? All right, watch the fingers. And see if there's a change of direction here with the ball. Boy, that angle's tough, but it almost looks like a field goal. Looks like it goes right in between the hands of Ronica Stone. What do you think, Kevin? All right, this will be a better angle, I think. Watch if it touches the either thumb. Actually, you know, it's tough. I don't think it does. Even though, I mean, it looks like it in slow motion. Just because the fingers don't move, the ball doesn't change direction, to me, there's no touch.
But initially call the touch, how much do you have to overrule it? Or initially called no touch,
right.
My bad.
And the call stands.
Confirmed. We have 2 matches tomorrow night. We invite you to come back. We'll be on AU Pro Sports YouTube and Facebook worldwide to start the evening. And we'll finish here on CBS Sports Network, same time as this match kicked off. That'll be 10 p.m. Eastern, 9 p.m. local time here in Dallas. And following that, immediately, you can watch live Saturday after the match. Tune in for our closing ceremony event. AU Pro Sports YouTube and Facebook back to there again. Find out who will be the Defensive Player of the Year. That GEICO winner will take home $5,000. You also find out the champion and watch the champion inscribe the Book of Unlimited and so much more. Closing ceremony coming your way. AU Pro Sports, YouTube and Facebook.
I wonder if Betty started thinking about what pen she'll use.
Not yet. Still using that right arm for kills, as is Ari Cruz, and there's another. Maximal effort from Madison Valines, not quite enough, 21-15.
Love the hustle that we see. Every point matters. And it shows in the max effort that we see every single time. Madison Valines doing everything she can to keep that ball in play while also protecting her body from the scoreboard.
Outside. Pushed through number 88. No block that time. Tamo with the heat. .170 to .310, the difference in hitting efficiency.
That has everything to do with Betty De La Cruz and Auri Cruz just crushing it on the outside for Team De La Cruz.
It's Sara Tomcom with a nice joust move. Nomara's charging, left hand saves it. Betty deep corner.
Basically, if there's Cruz in your name or in your team, you're doing something right.
There's kills in your stat line.
Yeah.
22-16, looking for the clean sweep here.
Speaking of, you see a lot of maintenance on the court tonight. It is very hot and humid inside the Coliseum tonight, so a lot more time keeping the court safe in between plays.
And more expected tomorrow. Going to be a little warmer in Dallas. That one is just a bit outside. Flat serve. No swing. Half take advantage. Good touch from Rosenthal. Back to her higher this time. Morgan chips it. More nice defense from Cruz. And another big cut from Kalei Mao back on the left-hand side. She's taking a couple of huge swings.
Yeah, that's her comfort zone. That's her bread and butter. Kalei earlier talked about the timing and how different it is. This time she's got more time with that go set to power it right through the hands of Taylor Morgan.
Can Betty do it? Already with a turkey in this one. Two more would finish it off. Tip shot is good.
Boy, that last serve was so much heat. 53 miles an hour for her highest velocity serve of the night. Doesn't pay off, though. And so disappointing. You just want to kind of finish it out with Betty serving. Like,
that would have been cool.
Just racking up points in that rotation.
Make sure the floor is safe. If you make a move, especially an approach jump, you try and take off a wet floor, bad things can happen.
Absolutely, instant wipeout. Everybody getting involved in the cleanup.
And Heather Cox excited about the music.
You're on to me.
A What a miraculous comeback. This would be trailing by just five. Oh, now to a set ball. All but assured for De La Cruz, the sweep. And Betty looking good for the championship.
Right now it's all about defense for De La Cruz. Can they score it on a block or dig behind the block to convert for a point?
Rosenthal is long, second opportunity coming here. And where do you go? You got Ronica Stone, Kalei Mao, and Ari Cruz.
They got a good pass. You can run Stone in the middle, but I mean, why not go to Cruz? She's been the go-to player all night long.
Or Betty down the middle. She is on the ground outside. Mao. Net violation. 25-19. 180 points for Team De La Cruz.
Excellent sweep behind incredible outside hitter play. Ari Cruz finishing the night with 15 kills. Betty De La Cruz with 17, a wonderful 1-2 punch as Team De La Cruz pulls Team Valentin-Anderson into the net on match point.
No team points on the other side, but 180 points for Team De La Cruz. 75-61 back to Dallas on a Friday, almost Saturday. Back in Dallas, our Geico defensive play of the game.
Jenna Rosenthal, no surprise, at middle blocker, just patrolling the net from antenna to antenna. The swing block for the stuff. Jenna Rosenthal with three blocks, ties a career high for the third time. Watch her reach in that time to close the seam. A show and then take. And that is your Geico defensive play of the game.
End of the season, we'll be awarding the Geico Defensive Player of the Year. The Athletes Unlimited Award comes with an extra $5,000 bonus. Team De La Cruz, 75-61. And perfect that we have the reigning Geico Defensive Player of the Game, who is safe in water conditions, the law firm of Nomaris, Velez, and Augusto. Nomaris, you guys, 83 digs tonight. You're anchoring that defense as well as passing. Tell me, what was the strategy coming in? What worked?
Just fight every ball and take care of every player, every single play in the game. So just helping my team.
Noma, you had 14 digs all by yourself. What was the key to you to read the attackers, the shoulders? Like, how are you getting all those looks?
Yeah, that for me, that's the key. Read the shoulder of every play. Sometimes it's harder, but today was a good day, so I'm super excited, and thanks God.
How much extra energy, extra momentum, extra everything are you guys giving to this for your captain, Betty De La Cruz, to get the overall championship tomorrow?
We are giving all. We are giving all ourselves to play every single game for her and for every single player in the team, because we all deserve that.
Do you like having Fair on the sidelines?
Of course. He's always so happy and just making me laugh.
Betty, thanks very much. Nomaris, Betty is celebrating. You guys are on your way, 75-61. Congratulations.
Thank you, thank you.
Can hop in a pool now.
Another night of volleyball in the books for Heather Cox, Key Michael, and our entire Athletes Unlimited crew. I'm Kevin Barnett. In this one, it was 75-61. Team De La Cruz. Reminder, the final night of Athletes Unlimited Volleyball starts 7 p.m. Eastern tomorrow night at auprosports.com. We'll be right back here on CBS Sports Network for the finale. We're going to hand out all the hardware, and the title will be decided. Come back and join us on a Saturday night, won't you?